Now this is starting to look kind of messy, so I'm just going to do cleanup blocks. Okay, that just gives everything in a nice vertical line. And what I'm going to do is go to the form screen and form screen initialize. So this says whenever I open up the screen, I want to make sure certain things are happening. And in our case, we want to turn on the visibility of this. And we want to turn off the visibility of everything else. So there should be false for login arrangement. Form arrangement also going to be false. And I'm going to duplicate that. And this will be our entry arrangement, also false. So every time we open this screen, this will be the setup. Login buttons will be visible and the other ones will be invisible. Now let's remember what will happen when the user first opens the screen. They will either create a new user if they already haven't, and ultimately log in. So it will be in this login procedure, where in this case we've set login arrangement to false. So what we want to show is the form arrangement. So once they've logged in, that's what we want to show. So let's set this to true. Okay, so we're going to hide the buttons and show the form arrangement, which should show whatever is currently in that list view, and then the button to make a new entry. Let's test this out. So I'm going to go back to screen one. I have my emulator open, so we're back at screen one. I'm going to click on Community Forum. So this will be my new user. So I'm going to, again, do a new user. Know that at this point, we're not saving the users to anything other than a variable. So that's going to disappear every time we run this. So I'm going to do my name and password again. Submit. Success. So now I will log in with Karen and test. Submit. Okay, so I've got a successful login, and I've got my list view, which we can't see anything now because it's white and it's empty, and make new entry. So this seems to be working. So far, so good. We want to now start to code the actual form interaction part. The first thing we want to do is to create a variable. And this is going to hold our form items. So I'm going to name this form. I'm going to initialize it to an empty list. Essentially, what we're going to do initially for this is display a list of messages. And you can add a message to the list. For now, that's all we're going to do, is just a simple list. Where are we going to get the contents of this form? Well, it's going to be stored in CloudDB. So what we're going to do is go back to Form Screen Initialize, and we're going to the first thing when we open the screen is to get the current state of the form from CloudDB. So we're going to call this getValue. So CloudDB works similar to a dictionary where you have a key and a value. They call it a tag. So the tag, we are going to create a tag name. So it's just like naming a variable. We give it a name. We're going to call this diabetes forum. If there is nothing there, we are going to return an empty list. So what essentially happens is we call CloudDB, we say, please give us the value of the diabetes forum. Once it has that information, it sends it back. It does not necessarily happen immediately. Once CloudDB returns the value, the got value event is triggered, and it returns the information with, if you notice, the two inputs are tag and value. Most often within an app, you could have multiple tags. So generally, it's good practice to first test to make sure we're using the correct tag. So we're going to say if tag, and I'm going to copy this. If the tag is equal to diabetes forum, then what we want to do is set the forum to the value that's returned, which is the list. Ultimately, we want this to be displayed, and we want it to be displayed in the items list view. So if we add this set items list view elements to, and we can either do value or forum because they're both the same, but I'm going to copy that, and we will set item list view elements to the list of messages. Now, when we start off with the app, the forum will be empty, so nothing's going to show up. In order to actually have something show up in our forum, we need to take care of adding a new entry. So let's go to the new entry button, when new entry button.click. And what we want to happen there is we want to make the entry arrangement appear and the form arrangement disappear. So form arrangement visible, let's set that to false. And let's set the entry arrangement visibility to true. In the entry arrangement, the user will type in what they want in the body text box, and then they will press the submit entry button. So when they submit, just going to move this over, what do we want to happen? So the body text box content, we want to add to our forum list. We are going to add items to list. And the list will be our forum. And the item is going to be bodytextbox.text. Now, one thing we might want to consider is let's make sure that there is something in the body text box before we add it. So let's add an if around that. That inside the if. So we will say if not, and in the text blocks there is an is empty. If not is empty, meaning there's something in it, then we'll add it to the forum. And then what we want to do is to also store it in the cloud. So we're going to go to CloudDB. And we are going to store, and the value is going to be diabetes forum. I'm sorry, the tag is going to be diabetes forum, and the value to store is going to be the forum. So we're going to store that in CloudDB. And then the last thing we want to do is let's clear out body text box. To blank again. And then let's see what else we want to do. We want to go back to the forum, don't we? So let's flip these again. So let's set entry arrangement to false and set form arrangement visibility to true. So that will hide the entry box and then bring back the forum. And then hopefully we will see our new message in the forum. Now we took care of in form screen initialize calling get value to get the current state of the forum, and we also included our gut value to get that. Now this happens when you first open the app. However, what happens when somebody adds something while you're using the app? The way that you handle that is with the CloudDB.dataChanged event. This happens whenever anyone using the app changes something in the forum. We want everyone that's using the app to get that updated information. Essentially, though, what we are going to do is once again check if the tag is diabetes forum, and if so, update the forum variable and also update the item list view. So we're going to use this. We could copy and paste this. The fact that we are going to do this in both places, though, I'm actually going to create a new procedure. Let's just give ourselves a little bit of space here. So the procedure is going to essentially do this. Let's call it Cloud DB update. And notice now tag and value aren't recognized. So I'm going to add two inputs to my procedure. And it's going to not like this. I'm going to drag these over so I can actually name these. And I'm going to name them tag and value. Okay, now I can throw these back in. Okay, so that means from both CloudDB data changed and CloudDB got value, we want to pass on the tag and value. And then we'll duplicate this and call it here. This might seem like overkill, but eventually we're going to be adding more tags, so it will be easier just to put it all in one place, so to put it in this procedure. Let's stop and test this. So let's go back to screen one. And I'm going to open the emulator. Click on Community Forum. Again, I'm going to put in a new user. So Karen, test, success, login, Karen, test. Okay, so we know that we have a successful login. We don't have any entries, so I'm going to make a new entry. So I'll just say this is a test forum message. Submit, and voila, now it's showing up in my list view. Let me make a new one. This is another forum message about diabetes. Submit. Okay, and so we've got now two. Now looking at this is a little big, the font. Once I got rid of the keyboard, we can see it a little better, but I still think that this might be a little bit big, so I'm going to go back to my designer for the list view, and I'm going to, let's make this, it's 22, I'm going to make it 14. And then what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to restart my emulator. So let me close out of here, and then I'm going to restart it again. So connect, reset, connect to the emulator. So now we're starting fresh again. So let's just to be on the safe side, go back to screen one as if we were logging in from the beginning, community forum. Once again, I'm going to have to use a new user. And this is something we're going to fix because each time, because I'm not saving my users anywhere, I'm going to have to create that new user every time. So we will fix that in a minute, but let's just test that both of my messages show up. Okay, so this is, we reset the size here, but also this is proving that we are getting our information from CloudDB each time. So we want to be saving not only the forum to CloudDB, we want to be saving the users and their passwords to CloudDB too, so that anyone can log in from anywhere. So what we want to do is find our new user. Here in this else is where we have a successful new user and we add the username and their password to the user's dictionary. Well, not only do we want to save it here, but we also want to save it in CloudDB. So let's go to CloudDB and add a store value. And we need a new tag here. So I'm going to call this forum users. And the value to store is going to be the global users. So we will store that value. Now we need to go back up to our CloudDB update, right? And we have to add another if statement. So I'm going to actually duplicate this, and we're going to say if the tag is forum users, I want to set users to the value. Okay, and we don't need that for that situation. I had mentioned before we'll be adding multiple tags, and that's why we created this procedure. So we only have to update it in one place, not in two places. And then the other thing we need to do is when we first start up in forum screen initialize, we want to get the value for forum users. So when forum screen opens, forum screen initialize will trigger. It will call got value for both of these tags, and then CloudDB got value will be triggered for both of them and update both tags and their values. If we now decide to test this, we can go to the emulator. What I've noticed is that we are stuck in this arrangement again, like before. So we need a way to get back minimally to the home screen. Okay, so what I want to do is go back to the designer. And we are going to add, and let's just add a button by itself down here. And let's name this home button. We're going to do the same thing we did before, is we're going to make the image equal to the little home. It's too big, so we're going to change the height and width to 50 pixels. And let's go back to blocks and code that. Home button, when home button click. And what we want to do then is just close the screen. So once again, screen one will call this, and so it's going to be sitting behind the screen. So when we want to return to screen one, we just want to close the screen. Now we should be able to test. So we've got the home button. Let's go back and start over. Once again, we haven't saved anything yet, so we're going to do a new user. Karen, test, test. Success. I have to log in. Okay, I've got my entries. Let's do another one. This is yet another topic. Submit. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to close this and retest or reset my connection and do the emulator again. Back to screen one once again. And community forum. This time we should be able to log in. Karen, test. Beautiful. So now we've got the three messages from before, and I was able to log in directly with my username and password.